Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Dentistry Media. We will discuss about the complement system in detail. The complement system is an integral part of the innate immune response. They play a key role in defense against the pathogens and in maintaining the host homeostasis. They are so called because they complement or fulfill the action of specific antibodies. As we know, the antibodies can target a microorganism for destruction, but they cannot directly kill them. Therefore, these complement proteins, they augment the opsonization of the bacteria by antibodies, thereby enhancing their destruction. These complement proteins, therefore, they act as a bridge between the innate and the acquired immunity. But remember, they can also act in the absence of antibodies. The complement system consists of 30 plasma proteins. They are mostly synthesized in the liver, specifically C3, C6 and C9. Significant amounts are also produced by membrane proteins expressed on the cell surface of tissue macrophages, specifically C2 and C4. C5 and C8 are produced by spleen. Epithelial cells of intestine produce C1 and smaller amounts are also produced by the genitourinary system. These complement proteins mostly circulate in the serum in functionally inactive form, known as the proenzymes or the zymogens. They need to be activated, and on activation they react in a specific sequence as a cascade. There are three known pathways for complement activation. Those are the classical pathway, the alternative pathway and the lectin pathway. And the ultimate aim is to cause the lysis or damage of the target cell. We will first see the classical pathway in detail. The classical pathway is majorly activated by the antigen-antibody immune complexes. The class of antibodies that fix complement are the IgM or IgG, specifically IgG 3, 1 and 2, but not by IgG 4, IgA, IgD or IgE. Therefore, the fixation of complement is not influenced by the nature of antigens, but only by the class of immunoglobulins. There are the other proteins which can activate the classical pathway other than the antibodies. Those include the C-reactive protein, the viral proteins, the polyanions, the apoptotic cells, and also the amyloid. The classical pathway is so called because it was first identified. It is also called as a specific active immunity. I have used the lysis of bacteria sensitized by its antibody to explain the classical pathway. So the bacteria is the antigen which is attached by a specific antibody to form the antigen-antibody complex. What happens in a complement cascade is a series of reactions occur in which the preceding component, they act as enzyme on the succeeding component, thereby cleaving them into dissimilar fragments. The larger fragments, they join the cascade, and the smaller fragments, they have other biological effect. And the first complement component which attaches to the antigen-antibody complex is C1, which is a macromolecule, and it attaches to the antibody by its C1 Q globular head. So it attaches to at least two antibodies and to form a stable interaction. And this attachment happens in the presence of calcium ion, which leads to the further activation of C1R and C1S. This C1S is an enzyme esterase, which is required for splitting the next complement component, that is C4, into C4A and C4B. This C4B, it joins the cascade. The C4B, in the presence of magnesium, it splits the molecule C2 into C2A and C2B. This C2B, it has kinin-like activity and they increase the permeability. And the C2A is a larger molecule which joins the cascade to form the compound, that is C1-4B2A, which has an enzymatic activity which is represented by this bar. And they are called as C3 convertase because they split the C3 into C3A and C3B. This C3A, it has chemotactic and anaphylactic property and they are released into the plasma. And this C3B is a larger fragment which joins the cascade to form the compound, which is called as C5 convertase. The membrane attack phase begins with the formation of the C5 convertase, which splits this C5 into C5A and C5B. The C5A has chemotactic and anaphylactic properties similar to C3A, and the bigger molecule C5B joins the cascade, which further combines with C6 and C7 to form the C5B67 molecule. This molecule, it has two important properties, that is, they amplify the reaction by getting adsorbed to the adjacent bystander cell, thereby making them susceptible to lysis by C8 and C9. Also, smaller amount of this molecule gets attached to the bacterial cell membrane, thereby preparing them for lysis by C8 and C9. Also, a smaller amount of unbound C5-6-7 molecule is shown to have chemotactic and leukocyte activating property, but the effect is transient due to its rapid inactivation. This C5B6-7, it recruits C8 from the plasma and multiple copies of C9 to form the MAC complex. That is C5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. This is a large channel which pierces the bacterial cell membrane, thereby disrupting the osmotic integrity of the bacterial cell, leading to lysis of the bacteria. This is the whole process of complement-mediated lysis, which is the primary way by which the antibody-coated bacteria are killed. So if you see this bacteria, the antigen, after they are attached by their antibodies, the complement proteins are triggered and in a series they get activated to ultimately form the MAC complex. This MAC complex, it inserts itself into the cell as a channel or pore, ultimately causing the lysis of the target cell or the antigen or the bacteria. Therefore, this complement proteins, as they are called, they complement or complete the action of the antibodies. Now let's see the alternative pathway in detail. The alternative pathway contributes to antimicrobial defense without requiring specific antibodies. The central process here is the activation of C3. They can be activated by a wide range of substances, including immunoglobulins IgA, IgD, bacterial endotoxin, yeast cell wall. Others also include cobra venom factor and nephritic factor. Now let us see the alternative pathway in detail. This C3b, they are continuously generated in small quantities in the circulation and they are present as a free state. But they are rapidly inactivated by the serum protein, that is factor H and factor I. So whenever there is a presence of an endotoxin or an activator, the C3b binds with the endotoxin to form the C3b bound form, which escapes the inactivation by such protein. And this bound compound, in the presence of magnesium ion, it interacts with the serum protein called as the factor B to form this molecule. This factor B, it is also called as the C3 proactivator. The factor B portion of the complex is split by the serum protein factor D, which is also called as a C3 proactivator convertase, into two molecules. In that, the molecule capital to small b, it joins the cascade to form the complex, which is also called as the C3 convertase of alternative pathway. But this enzyme is extremely labile and it is stabilized by the factor P or the propyridine factor. Therefore, this C3 convertase further splits C3 into C3A and C3B, and the remaining action is same as that in the classical pathway. Now let us see the lectin pathway in detail. The mannan binding lectin, these are the acute phase proteins which are produced during the inflammatory responses. They are involved in the first line defense mechanism. They recognize and bind to the specific carbohydrate targets, that is the mannose residues which are present on the pathogen surface. As they attach to this mannose residue, they are so called. The mannose residues are found in pathogens such as Salmonella, Neisseria, Listeria, Cryptococcus neoformans, Candida albicans and etc. After this mannan binding lectin binds to the pathogen, specific proteases, namely mannose binding lectin associated serine proteases 1 and 2 are activated, and they form a complex, that is an active complex, which is similar to the C1 complex which is formed in the classical pathway. This active complex causes cleavage and activation of C4 and C2 to form the C3 convertase. The rest of the pathway is similar to that of classical pathway. The lectin pathway is involved in the first line of defense because it does not depend on the antibody for its activation, and it represents an innate defense mechanism which is comparable to the alternate pathway, while the mechanism is more like the classical pathway, that is, it utilizes the same classical pathway components except C1 proteins. And also, the human cells are spared from binding because they contain sialic acid residues covering the sugar groups. Therefore, they are not recognized by the mannan binding protein and they are not the target for binding. The biological events of complement activation are as follows. The first is the lysis, that is cytolysis or bacteriolysis. These complement proteins, they mediate immunological membrane damage through the insertion of the MAC complex, which would disrupt the cell membrane, thereby causing their lysis. The MAC complex can lyse a broad spectrum of cells, including the gram-negative bacteria. Especially Neisseria species are highly susceptible to the MAC complex. The others include the erythrocytes, parasites, viruses and nucleated cells. Second is opsonization. The complement protein C3b acts as an opsonin. The process is called as opsonization, wherein the microbes such as bacteria and viruses are phagocytosed much better in the presence of the opsonin C3b, because C3b receptors are present on the surfaces of many phagocytes. Therefore, the complement proteins enhance phagocytosis by marking an antigen. The next is the clearance of the immune complexes and the apoptotic cells by the process of phagocytosis. The coating of the soluble immune complexes with the C3b facilitates their binding to the CR1 on the erythrocytes. These erythrocytes transfer these immune complexes to the liver and spleen where they are phagocytosed. The next is viral neutralization. The antibodies and complements, they play a major role in the defense against viruses, that is, they protect viral infection spread and also the occurrence of reinfection. What happens is the binding of antibody or the complement on the surface of the viruses prevents or blocks its attachment to the susceptible host, thereby neutralizing the viral infectivity. And also the deposits of complements and antibodies on the viral particles facilitates phagocytosis. The next is the inflammatory response. The fragments released during the complement cascade reaction helps in amplifying and triggering the inflammatory response. The first is the C2, which has a kinin-like activity, which induces a smooth muscle contraction and increases the vascular permeability. The next is C3A and C5A. They have anaphylatoxic and chemotactic activity. They bind to the receptors on the mast cells and blood basophils, thereby causing degranulation, that is, release of histamine and other mediators of inflammation. And the next is C567, which has a chemotactic and reactive lysis activity. It induces the neutrophils and monocytes to adhere to the endothelial cells of the blood vessel, thereby extravasate and migrate to the inflammatory site. The complement system participates in the cytotoxic, that is type 2, for example, transfusion mismatches, and in type 3, that is immune complex, for example, arthritis reaction and serum sickness hypersensitivity reactions. In case of endotoxic shock, there is massive fixation of the complement C3 and platelet adherence, which causes large-scale platelet lysis and release of large amount of platelet factor, leading to disseminated intravascular coagulation and thrombocytopenia. The gram-negative septicemia and dengue hemorrhagic syndrome, they have similar pathogenesis. The unrestrained complement activation can cause severe tissue injury and even systemic anaphylaxis. Therefore, there are several inbuilt control mechanisms that regulate the complement cascade at different steps. They are of two kinds. Those are the inhibitors and the inactivators. These inhibitors, they bind to the complement components and halt their further function. And these inactivators are enzymes which destroy the complement proteins. First, we'll see the inhibitors. C1 esterase, these are normally present in the serum, and this does not prevent normal progress of the complement cascade, but it checks the autocatalytic prolongation, that is, the C1 esterase irreversibly binds to and inactivates the C1R and C1S, thereby it inhibits the initiating step of the classical pathway. The second inhibitor is the S protein. It is normally present in the serum and it binds with the C6-7 complement enzyme and modulates the cytolytic action of the MAC complex. The The inactivators includes factor I, which is also known as the C3b C4b inact or cognitinogen activating factor or KF, and the second inactivator is the factor H. Both the inactivators are beta globulins which are present in the serum, and they majorly control the C3 activity of the alternative pathway. The next is the anaphylatoxin inactivator. It is an alpha globulin and it enzymatically degrades the anaphylatoxins released during the cascade. Those are the C3a, C4a and the C5a. And the C4 binding protein also controls the activity of the cell bound C4b. The protection of the human cells from lysis by the MAC complex of the complement is mediated by the decay accelerating factor. It is also represented as DAF or CD55. It is a glycoprotein located on the surface of the human cells, and it limits the formation of C3 convertase and C5 convertase. This happens by binding to the C3b and C4b. Thereby, it prevents the formation of the MAC complex. The complement deficiency results in the host being unable to eliminate the microbial antigen or the circulating immune complexes, thereby making the persons more susceptible to recurrent bacterial, fungal and collagen diseases. The complement deficiency can be either complete or partial. The deficiency of the early components of the classical pathway, that is C1, C2 and C4, predispose the person to conditions such as systemic lupus erythematosus or other collagen diseases. The deficiency of C2, which is the most common complement deficiency, is associated with streptococcal infection and lupus-like syndrome. And the deficiency of the central component of the complement, that is the C3 and its regulatory protein and C3b inactivator, predisposes the persons to severe recurrent pyogenic infections. In case of deficiency of the terminal component of the complement system, that is the C5 to C9, the persons are at increased risk from recurrent nasal infections such as invasive meningococcal and disseminated gonococcal infections when compared to the general population. The decay accelerating factor is an inactivator of the MAC complex. Therefore, in case of acquired or inherited deficiency of the decay accelerating factor, results in an increase in the MAC complex activity, leading to increased complement-mediated lysis, particularly of the red blood cells, that is hemolysis, and clinically this appears as the disorder paroxysmal nocturnal hemoglobinuria. The C1 inhibitor has an important role in the complement regulation, and its deficiency causes a condition called as the hereditary angioneurotic edema, which is an autosomal dominant clinical condition. It is characterized by episodic angioedema of the subcutaneous tissue or of the mucosa of the respiratory tract or the alimentary tract, and it is a non-pitting type of edema. Therefore, the deficiency of C1 inhibitor leads to autocatalytic activation of C1, which further causes unrestrained breakdown of C4 and C2. As we know, C2 as a kinin-like activity, which is the main mediator of the edema. In this case, the levels of C1 is normal and C2 and C4 are depleted. The acquired deficiency of the complement system may result from severe liver diseases, for example, alcoholic cirrhosis or chronic hepatitis, wherein the person would have lost significant liver function and therefore they cannot synthesize sufficient amount of the complement proteins, thereby predisposing the persons to pyogenic infections. The complement system is generally effective in lysing the gram-negative bacteria. However, some gram-negative and most gram-positive bacteria have mechanism to evade the complement-mediated damage. So let us see one by one. The first is the resistant strains of E. coli and Salmonella. These, they prevent the insertion of the MAC complex into their cell wall because of the presence of the lipopolysaccharide. So if you see, this is the image of the gram-negative bacterial cell wall, and these are the lipopolysaccharides, which contains the core and the O-specific side chain. In case of resistant strains of E. coli and Salmonella, these side chains are very long. Thereby, they act as a physical barrier for the insertion of the MAC complex. The complement system plays an important role in combating the nasal infections. In case of resistant strains of Neisseria gonorrhoeae, the cell membrane contains membrane protein which interacts with the MAC complex and prevents its insertion. Pseudomonas aeruginosa is an extracellular opportunistic pathogen which evades the complement-mediated damage by the production of large number of extracellular products such as toxins and proteases, that is elastase, which inhibits the complement activity by inhibiting the anaphylatoxin such as C3A and C5A. In case of gram-positive bacteria, that is a streptococcus, the cell wall are very thick, thereby they prevent the insertion of the MAC complex. So this is the image of the bacterial cell wall of a gram-positive bacteria, and you can see the peptidoglycan layer, it is very thick. Thereby, they prevent the insertion of the MAC complex. The bacteria Streptococcus pneumoniae, it has a polysaccharide capsule which completely encloses the bacteria and it is a dominant structure. It plays a key role in its virulence because it acts as a physical barrier and it inhibits the complement activity and also prevents or inhibits phagocytosis. So if you remember, this capsule, it can be demonstrated as a clear halo in India ink preparation. Viruses, fungi and protozoans such as the Epstein-Barr virus, herpes simplex, vaccinia virus, Toxoplasma cruzi and Candida albicans, they contain a protein which mimic the mammalian complement regulatory proteins. Thereby, they inhibit the complement cascade. To summarize, the critical step in the functioning of the complement system is the activation of the complement C3, IgM and IgG. To be more specific, more of IgM than IgG are responsible for the activation of the classical pathway, and IgA is required for the activation of the alternative pathway. The C3A and C5A, they act as anaphylatoxins, and also C5A has an important role in chemotaxis. C3B acts as an opsonin, and the deficiency of the complement C1 inhibitor leads to hereditary angionecrotic edema. Thank you for watching and do subscribe for more videos related to dentistry.